Welcome to VMblog's coverage of VMware Explore 2023 taking place in Las Vegas. And today I have the pleasure of having Yogesh Anyapanawar, who's the co-founder and CEO of Datamotive. Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Brian and David, for having me. Pleasure to speak with you folks.
Now, I don't think we've spoken before. Maybe you can give our members a quick overview of the company.
Absolutely. So at Datamotive, we have essentially built a very innovative hybrid multi-cloud workload portability platform. Now, this platform essentially enables seamless mobility of entire workloads across public and private clouds with a flatline recovery SLA of 10 minutes. And this is, of course, irrespective of what your source cloud is, what your target cloud is, what actual application stacks you're running on it, or actually the size of the workload in itself, right? It's well accepted now that the hybrid multi-cloud model, right, is going to be the future, right, if not already so, for cloud computing and for all types of organizations. With this increasing need for this model, organizations will require a solution to move their workloads between clouds seamlessly, securely, efficiently, right? And most importantly, without compromising on their efforts, their operations, and their SLAs. Gartner has been mentioning about cloud portability for quite a long time. It's been in the reports for a few years now. And the need for organizations to adopt and operate these environments is a must-have today. So Datamotive is exactly solving these challenges, right? We make it seamless for our enterprise customers to move from one cloud to another, whether it be the use case of workload mobility, whether it is business continuity, ransomware recovery, right? These are the three things that we talk about. From a background perspective, we've raised multiple rounds. We recently closed our Series A round as well with institutional VCs. And of course, we are using that money to expand into the US. And of course, this is our first foray into a VMware Explore event as well, especially in the US. We are graduates of the NetApp and Cisco Accelerator programs. We are partnering with them on a variety of ways, whether it is integrations at the product level or even joint go-to-markets. And of course, our technology has won multiple awards. One of the more the better ones was a Stevie Award that we won for emerging technology just a few months back. But yeah, that's about Datamotive.
Well, today we're here to talk about VMware Explore, the event that you're a part of. If you would, maybe talk a little bit about how your company is partnering and working with VMware.
Absolutely. So, VMware has been a pioneer in building solutions for this hybrid multi-cloud environment, right? They're primarily focusing on consistency of infrastructure across multiple clouds, the operations, the ease of use, right? All of those things. And Datamotive aligns perfectly well with all of these goals, right? With Datamotive, we are actually trying to accelerate the adoption of this hybrid multi-cloud model, right? Essentially implement this in the day-to-day strategy for all our enterprise customers. And there are obvious uses of having a variety of cloud environments at your disposal rather than just trying to get locked in into a single one of them. Now, we are, of course, Technology Alliance partners with VMware, along with all the other clouds as well. And we are trying to essentially elevate the offering that VMware already has by adding the Datamotive offerings and making it seamless for people to either move from VMware into a VMware cloud model or even from public clouds back into VMware.
And what exactly do you guys offer somebody who already has a current VMware implementation? You know, what kind of problems do you solve for them and why would they be interested in to come see your booth?
Absolutely. So, Datamotive's offerings primarily lie around three primary areas, right? First is from the workload mobility perspective. And we define a workload as a collection of your operating system, the application, the data for that application. Everything is put together into a single black box for Datamotive. And we actually offer the ability to move this to any other target platform. Right? So from a VMware perspective, we are primarily offering migration of workloads into the VMware cloud. We also offer business continuity, primarily in terms of disaster recovery. where we can actually enable a VMware shop to actually have their DR site on, for example, an AWS, and consolidate all of their DR sites, or if they're already in a hybrid multi-cloud model, maybe choose VMware as their DR site itself, right? And if they could actually have their production environments running on either AWS or Azure or any other cloud for that matter. Third, Datamotive actually allows to consolidate all of these deployments into a single model. So regardless of what your primary production site is, you can actually consolidate all of these together from your business continuity purpose. And of course, with Datamotive, we solve the adoption, the challenges around operations, right, that organizations face within this hybrid multi-cloud journey that they will embark upon. So it's primarily focused on disaster recovery, workload migrations, ransomware recovery is another area that we're working towards too. But yes, these are the three major offerings. And of course, we have live demos of all of this at our booth at VMware Explore. We are at booth 815, right? And we would love to get as many people and actually showcase our products in a working environment while we're at that.
Yeah, and hopefully we can maybe in this video get a little bit of a demo as well ahead of the show.
Absolutely.
The technology sounds great. Is there any way you can maybe dive in a little bit deeper into the actual technology just to give us a bit more of an understanding?
Sure, absolutely. So at the core of Datamotive is a purpose-built, patented replication and recovery engine, right? What this engine essentially does from a replication perspective, right, is that it's an online agentless block level, hypervisor level, incremental replication engine, which is continuously replicating the data from your source platform to your target platform. Right? And of course, this is, as I said, it's all incremental. So only the data that has changed, only the delta is actually going to get replicated at user-defined intervals. This engine is also WAN optimized for enterprise-grade customers. So there is encryption, deduplication, compression already built into the system. And it is, of course, all seamless. It's an agentless replication engine, as I mentioned. So zero impact on security on the actual workload or even performance on the actual workload. We move that black box in its entirety, right? And this is completely, so for example, Datamotive, if we want to replicate a VMware instance to, let's say, a AWS EC2 instance, that entire instance is replicated. So what you had on the source is actually what you get on the target. And to add to all of this technology in terms of agentless replication, the recovery engine enables native cloud recovery. So when you're actually recovering that instance is now recovered as a native EC2 instance, right? It's no longer a VMware instance. And we achieve that with an SLA of 10 minutes. This is a flatline SLA of 10 minutes, regardless of what applications are running inside, what is the actual size of the data, right? Whether it is 10 GB of data or 50 GB of data or even 10 terabytes of data. Right? Datamotive only requires 10 minutes to completely start up that instance on the target cloud within its format in that instance. Right. Now, all these things put together, and this replication engine and recovery engine is, of course, bidirectional. So just the way we move from, let's say, VMware to AWS, we can bring workloads from AWS and Azure into VMware as well in the same fashion. So it's a fully enterprise grade bidirectional replication and recovery engine. That is the work.
Now, you mentioned the bidirectional part. Do you think that would be one of your differentiating factors, or is there something specific that you think makes you stand out above? You know, obviously it's a big show, lots of vendors there, lots of competition. What's that one thing that makes Datamotive stand out?
Absolutely, Brian. So with Datamotive, we have a fair bit of differentiators, right? The aspect of business continuity and mobility within that hybrid multi-cloud environment, essentially enabling that seamless replication and recovery, right? So whether it is our agentless technology, whether it is our completely non-intrusive to the actual application is very important from a security perspective. Datamotive never knows whether you're running a database or a web application inside your workload. It's completely secure. It's a complete black box for Datamotive. Those aspects are cloud native recovery itself. And, you know, as you mentioned, our incremental reverse replication, that's one of the first features as we believe in the market today. And not to mention our 10-minute RTO SLA, whether we are trying to do a cutover from a migration use case or a recovery time objective from a disaster recovery use case, right? That 10-minute window to achieve all of these things and still get target native format is what we pretty sure is will be our differentiators and people will love about us.
During VMware Explore, a lot of companies use that time to showcase some new announcements that they're making. Is your company making, or maybe they've made some recent announcements, or are you making any new announcements during the show itself?
So we don't really have any new announcements, but we recently launched our solutions and our products within the US markets. So of course, it's the first foray for us. Our current products on the shelf are on the migration side and the disaster recovery side. And soon we'll be adding support and announcing our support for containers, support for other clouds as well, like Oracle Cloud or IBM Cloud, right? Which are also primarily large partners for VMware. So it fits in very nicely for what we are trying to do over here. But yes, it's our first foray into the US markets, especially in the North America. And with our recent funding, we are trying to expand pretty rapidly and build our base in the US.
Now, what kind of things are you guys looking at? What kind of themes and trends moving out of 2023 into 2024 that your company is interested in?
So clearly, the story with VMware is especially on the hybrid multi-cloud aspect, right? For the last couple of years, I would say. I've been attending VMware World or VMware Explore for a fairly long time. And I'm pretty sure that will also be the theme this year and in the coming years. And that aligns perfectly well with our strategy, as I mentioned earlier, what folks like Gartner are also trying to identify in their hype cycle report of why there is a need for the seamless portability aspect, right? You're actually, porting your workloads from one platform to another and why that is going to be important. Of course, we are also very much interested in looking at what new things VMware has turned up on the security side of things. Because that's also, especially when you run into this hybrid multi-cloud environments, the security of data, security of access, security of and control of that is also extremely important. So hopefully that is something that also aligns with what Datamotive is trying to do and achieve.
Yogesh, you've given us a great look into the company and the technology. I sort of asked a little bit earlier, but is there a way you can show us maybe a quick demo or just, let folks watching the video know what it kind of looks like?
Absolutely, absolutely. So for this particular demo, let me give a quick background of what you are trying to showcase, right? So it's actually a live demo. It's not a pre-recorded one, but we have chosen VMware as a typical production site, on-prem production environment. We have a set of applications defined essentially a three-tier set of applications with a database, a middle tier, and some load balancers on top configured on this VMware environment. In the demo, you will actually see that we are replicating these to AWS region, and we have actually recovered these instances as native AWS EC2 instances. And what we'll also showcase in the demo is that now we have enabled reverse replication back to VMware. Right. So maybe we are using AWS only for a week or a couple of days or so, right, until our VMware site is back up and running to its normal operations. So we have actually reversed the replication over to VMware as well and how that is currently in progress. So we'll showcase the hybrid multi-cloud aspect, right, the cloud native recovery. And of course, I'll show what kind of RTO times we got, what kind of SLAs we achieved while we were actually doing this.
Great.
Great. So what you see here is the Datamotive dashboard. We are currently logged into our VMware site, right? As I mentioned, we have quite a few virtual machines running on this VMware site as a production environment, right? From a dashboard perspective, in this particular environment, it's a pretty small setup. So we just have about 20 odd virtual machines that are running and getting replicated over to a target region. The total storage size is around 3 terabytes. You get to see some factors over here in terms of details around, you know, what the RPO is configured and average, the replication interval at which we are collecting the change data and replicating it to the target set, right? Some statistics, what is the overall analysis. We do monitor all the instances that we protect, so you get to see that data. But this site connection is what I definitely wanted to focus upon, right? So as you can see, there is data moving currently from this VMware site to AWS, and certain things are also getting replicated back, right? But whereas there is a one-way one-way replication setup between VMware and Azure, different instances that are getting replicated here as well, right? And we are also replicating it to a completely independent VMware center as well, which will most likely be either the cloud or a private data center. From showcasing what we are actually replicating, right, and how that works, let me quickly jump into a protection plan. This is where we actually categorize or group the virtual machines and the actual workloads, right? So as you can see on the top, originally it was from VMware to AWS, and now we have actually reversed the replication. So we are replicating it back from AWS into VMware side, right? These are all the virtual machines in question. As I mentioned, it's a three-tier app. There are a total of, I think, 7 different virtual machines that are actually getting replicated. Variety of operating systems, whether it is Windows, whether it is Linux, some of them are Ubuntu, some are Red Hat, and some are on Windows currently, right? But this is how the, you know, the replication jobs will also get shown, right? So when we are actually showcasing the replication, you will get to see the details of every replication interval, what change data we were dealing with, what was the total transferred, what kind of compression we actually got. So it significantly reduces your egress cost as well, right? When we are jumping in from one cloud to another. So these kind of things. And on the other side, let me also showcase our dashboard from the Datamotive AWS region. So currently it's basically exactly the same dashboard, absolutely nothing different. You get to see the data that you saw earlier as well, right? Let me actually go to the same plan. Right. So this is exactly the same plan with the same information that you see, the same 7 different virtual machines, right? And these are currently active and running on our AWS region. So this is US East 2 region that we are currently targeting, right? And this is where they are running. Now, if I go to our jobs and actually look at the recovery jobs, here we'll get to see all of our recoveries that we did for recovering these application sets with a part of the Talio business service, right? As you can see here, all of these instances, regardless of the size of data that they have, in this case, which was like a flatline 200 GB in all of these machines, right? We get an average of around just over 5.5 minutes of a RTO to actually recover them as native EC2 instances. Right. You'll get to see the details around all of these applications, what actually happened in the background, right? While we were actually recovering this, there is complete runbook automation on these recoveries. So if you want to do DNS updates, IP address changes, make any configurations to your applications, right? Configuration changes to your applications, all of that can be achieved through scripting. So all in all, what we have tried to do is provide a single click recovery. At a business service level. So, and that business services could be a collection of multiple instances. You don't have to go one by one, and you know, you can actually categorize them as tier one applications have different SLAs for that, tier two different SLAs for that, right? So you can actually cater it according to your recovery plans and your business needs. Now, as you can see from the configuration perspective, let me go back here. To our protection plan, right? And here you will actually be able to see that now that they are running on AWS, we are actually replicating it into VMware, right? So the recovery site is again the same original VMware side. And this protection plan is essential to reverse. Now, the beauty of Datamotive is that we are only going to replicate the data that changed while it was running in AWS. So even if there was a terabyte of data, right, that we actually replicated over to AWS originally, right, we are only going to bring back what changed, which might be just a handful of GBs. So this improves the mechanism in which, you know, the time it takes to actually recover these workloads when we are back in VMware, right? And that operational aspect is significantly reduced. You no longer have to replicate terabytes of data. You only bring back what changed in that environment. And that's the seamless aspect of the Datamotive plan. So that's what I had for the demo. Of course, when you're at the booth, we'll have significantly more details and we'll have more time to showcase or at least emulate a real disaster, do recovery and do migrations. And of course, we have demos scheduled every 2 hours at our booth, which is again booth number 815 of the Explore floor. And we'll get to see all the details around our migration and disaster recovery offerings.
Well, hey, we really appreciate that great demo, and I definitely, invite everyone who's watching to come by your booth and check it out in person. Before we let you go, where can folks go if they aren't going to be at the trade show itself to learn more about the company, the technology, and the things that we talked about today?
So all the information that we saw is available on our website, which is www.datamotive, that's datamotive.io. There are multiple ways to reach out to us. If you're not at the booth, just drop us a note on our website and we'll immediately get back to you. So absolutely available there. Plus, we plan to be at multiple shows within this year, especially in the US. So, of course, there is information around that. And we have our LinkedIn and Twitter feeds as well. So any mode of communication you prefer, even a one-liner statement, we would love to hear from you and get back to you on that.
Great. Well, Brian and I both look forward to seeing you in person at the trade show.
Thank you so much, David. Brian, pleasure speaking with you folks. Yeah. Thank you so much.